JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's weekly market outlook webinar for the week April the 5th until April the 9th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will describe the most important economic releases and events on the financial agenda for the week ahead. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, central banks return to the spotlight this week with the RBA monetary policy decision getting the ball rolling on Tuesday. Then on Wednesday and Thursday, we get the minutes from the latest FOMC and ECB meetings, respectively. While on Friday, the employment report for March from Canada is due to be released. Let's take things from the beginning. Today is Easter Monday in most nations under our radar, and thus the respective markets will stay closed. We only get some US data, with the most important ones being the final market services PMI for March and the ISM non-manufacturing index for the same month. The final market PMI is expected to be revised up to 60 from 59.8, while the ISM index is forecast to have risen to 58.5 from 55.3, underscoring the fast pace of the recovery in the world's largest economy. On Tuesday, during the Asian morning, the RBA decides on monetary policy. At their previous meeting, RBA officials kept their monetary policy unchanged and noted that the economic recovery is well underway and has been stronger than earlier expected. However, they also put at ease concerns over high inflation, noting that wage and price pressures are subdued and are expected to remain so for some years. In our view, this means that the bank is unlikely to start considering scaling back quantitative easing or rising interest rates anytime soon. What adds more credence to our view are comments by former RBA board member John Edwards, who on Friday noted that the bank will need to maintain its QE program for an extended period to prevent the Aussie from rising to high levels and thereby damage the economic recovery. The Aussie has surged more than 30% following its COVID-related slump to hit 0.80 against its US counterpart in February. Thereafter, it started to retreat. Remember that in November, the RBA started to buy long-dated bonds in order to narrow the yield differential with the US, which could keep a lid on the local currency. Now, with Aussie dollar trading at higher levels than in November, we see it very unlikely for policymakers to even start thinking about normalization. We expect them to repeat that they will maintain highly supportive monetary conditions until their goals are achieved, something they don't expect to happen until 2024, the earliest. Now, on Wednesday, the main event on the agenda may be the minutes from the latest FOMC gathering. At that meeting, policymakers decided to keep all their policy settings unchanged via unanimous vote, noting that bond purchases will continue until substantial further progress has been maintained towards their maximum employment and price stability goals. As far as the new dot plot is concerned, four members voted for hikes in 2022, while seven members saw the rates higher in 2023. But the median dots suggested that interest rates are likely to stay at present levels even in 2023. Now, even though officials upgraded their economic and inflation forecasts, with inflation now seen at 2.4% this year, Fed Chair Powell clearly said that this will be temporary and would not meet their standards. He also stuck to his guns that it's too early to discuss tapering quantitative easing. With all that in mind, we don't expect the minutes to paint a different picture. We believe that they will confirm that inflation is likely to rise and stay above 2% for some time in the years after 2023, and that it's too early to start discussing policy normalization. In our view, this is likely to ease further fears over high inflation in the months to come, and could also reduce speculation for higher interest rates sooner than previously anticipated. Equities are likely to continue their upside trajectory, while the US dollar and the safe haven Japanese yen may come under selling interest. As for Wednesday's data, during the EU session, we get the final services and composite PMIs for March from the Eurozone and the UK. As it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. From Canada, we get the IV PMI for March and the trade balance for February. We get the trade data from the US as well. Now on Thursday, we get more meeting minutes, this time from the ECB. At its latest meeting, this bank decided to accelerate its pandemic emergency purchase program in order to stop any unwarranted rise in bond yields. Although other major central banks share the view that the latest rise in bond yields around the globe just represents a healthy economic recovery, that's not the case for the ECB. Rising bond yields in Europe have partly spilled over from US markets reacting to President Biden's massive fiscal stimulus. Therefore, with Eurozone's economic recovery still being fragile, we will scan the minutes for hints and clues as to whether ECB officials stand ready to ease their monetary policy further if Eurozone bond yields remain elevated. Last week, President Lagarde noted that investors could test the bank's willingness to rein in rising borrowing costs as much as they want, and thus we believe that the minutes will show that policymakers will not hesitate to do more if needed. Finally, on Friday, the highlight on the schedule may be Canada's employment report for March. The unemployment rate is expected to have declined to 8% from 8.2%, while the net change in employment is forecast to show that the economy has added 90,000 jobs, following a 259,200 gain in February. After such a strong jobs growth in February, a slowdown in March appears more than normal to us, and thus we would consider this a decent report. When they last met, Bank of Canada officials kept monetary policy unchanged and noted that the economic recovery continues to require extraordinary monetary policy support until economic slack is absorbed so that the 2% inflation goals is sustainably achieved. According to the bank's January projections, this is not expected to happen until 2023. However, they reiterated that as they continue to gain confidence in the strength of the recovery, the pace of net purchases of government of Canada bonds will be adjusted as required. Something that may have kept the door for a QE tapering open. With that in mind, and this unemployment report may keep that option on the table and thereby support the Canadian dollar. As for the rest of Friday's data, during the Asian session, China's CPI and PPI for March are due to be released. The CPI rate is expected to have rebounded to plus 0.2% year over year from minus 0.2% in February, while the PPI rate is anticipated to have risen to 3.5% year over year from 1.7%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I hope you have a great week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next Monday. If you are interested in more detailed and frequent analysis, you can find me on our YouTube channel from Tuesday to Friday at around 7:30 a.m. GMT. So goodbye and have a nice day.
JFT, just fair and direct.